Let's open up the Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus console and create a workspace for ourselves. A workspace is a virtual environment that isolates access control for ingestion, storage, and querying of our Prometheus metrics. Once created, we can use the generated remote write URL to have our Prometheus server send metrics to the service. Now let's see how we can use Amazon Managed Service for Grafana to easily visualize, graph, and query these Prometheus metrics. Let's create a workspace within the Amazon Managed Grafana Service console by providing a name and clicking Next. Authentication will be handled through AWS Single Sign-On, which is enabled in the current region. Let's select the Service Managed permission type, which will set up the necessary permissions automatically. We'll select all the data sources supported by the service, and we'll also select Amazon Simple Notification Service for notifications. After reviewing the options selected, we can click Create Workspace. Now that the workspace has been created, we're going to assign users from AWS SSO so they can access the Grafana environment. Once users have been granted access permissions from the previous step, they can now access the Grafana workspace directly via this workspace URL without having to log into the AWS console. Let's click on the URL, enter our credentials in the AWS SSO login screen, and authenticate into Grafana. Here in this pre-created Grafana environment, we have a variety of dashboards and data sources configured. Let's add the Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus data source. We're going to give it a name, provide the workspace URL, and then save and test the endpoint after selecting the appropriate authentication option. We have a sample workload deployed in our environment using Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, Amazon Elastic Container Service, AWS Lambda, etc. Let's see the Kubernetes pod monitoring dashboard. Here, we can see the pod metrics collected by the Managed Prometheus service from the environment. The application also sends custom metrics in Prometheus format, and we can see them on the Pet Adoptions dashboard here. We can easily create a new panel by querying a new metric like this. Now let's take a look at the traces generated by the application to see how it's performing. Here, we're looking at a dashboard showing trace data from AWS X-Ray. We can see some request types seem to be slower than others, and we can also investigate a specific trace if needed. Here, we see a segment timeline that shows all the various interactions the application is having with different services. There's also a deep link to the AWS X-Ray console, which we can use to perform investigations on the trace request. This takes us directly to the trace details page on AWS X-Ray, shows the trace map, and also the segment timeline. We can continue our investigation from here using X-Ray Analytics if needed. This application also makes use of some AWS Lambda functions. Metrics collected from the AWS Lambda environment can be queried directly from Amazon CloudWatch. In this dashboard, we can see the AWS Lambda function performance data as well. We can also connect Amazon TimeStream as a data source. In this dashboard, we have sample time series data collected from a deployment environment. Powerful visualizations here can help us dive deep into a specific timeline for more thorough analysis. We can also take a look at a simple dashboard that fetches data from an Elasticsearch cluster. As you can see, it only takes a few clicks in the AWS console to easily create fully managed workspaces for collecting, querying, and storing our container metrics in the Managed Prometheus service, and instantly visualize the data in the Managed Grafana service, along with multiple other data sources, all in one console. For additional information on how to use Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus and Amazon Managed Service for Grafana, please refer to our website and the AWS documentation.